Thank you for that incredibly generous introduction. It's now my duty to disappoint you all thoroughly. I first discovered Poets and Players 2 years ago. I was working two jobs, 7 day week, 60 hours, and every spare moment I got, I was trying to squeeze in poetry. And I started to watch the YouTube videos religiously. And I learned so much. And it got me through some really awful shifts at work, just thinking, one day I'd really love to go and read there. So it's an absolute joy to be stood in front of you today and to be performing, so thank you. And in the theme of terrible jobs, my first poem is based on the experience of a friend who spent a day working on a battery egg farm and never went back. And this is what happened. It starts with a quote from John Berger, which is, "And in their glance was permanence. Brood." At 16, I did a day's work on an egg farm, a tin shed the size of a hangar. Inside its oven dark, 2,000 stacked cages, engines of clatter and squawk. My job, to sift a torch through the library of bars for the dead hens and pack a bin bag until it was tight as a pillow. All the time, my mind chanting, there is only one hen. Just one ruined hen repeated over and over. In this way, I soothe the sight of all that caged battery, their feathers stripped to stems, their wings like grills, their patches of scrotum skin. But what kept me awake that hot night in my box room as I listened to the brook outside chew on its stones and the fox's human scream was how those thousand birds had watched me. And really, it was me repeated over and over, set in the amber of their eyes. Me, the frightened boy in jeans stiff with chicken shit, carrying a bin bag full of small movement, a foot that opened, an eyelid that unshelled its blind nut, a beak mouthing a word. I think it's always important to start on a cheerful one, so just to get you in the mood. And in a seamless segue, I'm going to go from eggs to lemons. That makes sense in my mind, I'm sorry. With a poem called The Lemon Game. Wet yourself in Tesco. Mum's finger bullying your bladder until the hot purse pops wet in your jeans on the fruit and veg aisle. She toots and it sounds like a slap. Shakes her head. Dangerous. You are 5 years old, and together you are buying lemons for the lemon game. Walk a stranger's distance behind her all the way home. It's the stink of you, she says. Jeans, a honey rot blot, catching stares like wasps. Cold as nappy rash when you reach the flat. Sit still on the kitchen floor like a rabbit. Put your eyes front corners on her. Here is a sweet apple, sweet thing, she says. Drops down a lemon, green and yellow like an old bruise. Palm it up in a bite. Wax skin bursting, wetting you chin to chest, your mouth mulling the red taste, its soft clod, nothing like an apple's crunch, but she studies your face, referees your face, pours over your face like scalding kettle water. You know the rules. It must not screw up like a fist. It must not screw up like a fist. Just going to read two more, you'll be glad to know, after those two. This next poem, when I first wrote it, first draft, the working title was Bed Music, which might give you an idea of what it's about. But I thought, other than that being a terrible title, I thought it sounded too much like bad music. Bed music, bad music. So I changed it. And it was only much later, after I'd sent it out, I realised that the new title sounds like something a bit worse. So this is Sheet Music. I wake to his smell, thick as a bass string, to his sleeping back sheened in its resin. I lilt a finger against him, hairs on his skin, an orchestra lifting their bows. Then I stroke, trill the keys in his spine, see his shade turn on its red volume. I finger the small plectrum behind the neck, make him peel in a bell shiver, make him turn, eyes loud with their pupils. And just before I read my final poem, I just want to say thank you so much for coming today and for listening. It's been a massive honour to read amongst such fantastic poets today, so thank you. The Tilt. Those days when Mum's hangover was a dark kitchen, head in her hands like a full bowl sat at the table. I'd slip out of the house and come here, this bookshop on Luke Street. In here, I could shut the world with a door and be walled in by hardbacks, boxes of dead leaves, paperbacks neat as piano keys. In here, it was quiet, floorboards tense as a frozen lake, the book in my chest that opened and closed. And I'd kneel to a low shelf, choose at random, and break open a loaf of paper. It didn't matter that I couldn't afford it, or that soon the owner would make me leave, or that I was only four and couldn't read. The smell of an old book is a memory of trees. A boy can tilt into it the way a drunk tilts her glass and lean back, emptied. Thank you so much.